Hello, my name is Rebekah Bain, and I am from Milwaukee, Wisconsin. I'm a recent graduate from the University of Wisconsin-Milwaukee with an MA in History and a Master of Library and Information Science with an archival concentration. This summer, I am working in the manuscript reading room.
Hello, my name is Magdalene Jensen, and I am from Fort Worth, Texas. I'm a graduate student at Catholic University of America studying Library and Information Science with a concentration in Data Science. This summer, I am working with the manuscript reading room.
Our project explores the web metrics of two presidential collections that are available through the Library of Congress's digital collections, namely the Jefferson Papers and the Grant Papers. The web metrics software captures the amount of traffic on the digital collection site. The Jefferson Papers were added in 1999, one of the first digital presidential collections, and the Grant Papers were added in 2017, which provides a point of contrast.
The goal of our project is to analyze selected data from both the Jefferson and Grant papers to find insights into how digital collections are being utilized by researchers and to make suggestions for the Manuscript Division's online resources. Questions we have asked in our preliminary analysis include, what are the differences in the most commonly accessed items in each collection? Are there correlations between views and the Library of Congress's social media pages? And how do the presidential collections compare to one another? Additionally, our project will help suggest methods of data analysis for future collected data. In March of 2020, the Jefferson Papers had 27,766 views. In our graph, you will see the top 29 access URLs associated with the Jefferson Papers, which account for 12,217 of these views. Secondary sources are displayed in blue, which include online information, commonly referred to as conceptual framework, written by the Manuscript Division staff. In red, you will see primary sources or collection items. The most frequently viewed items include both the draft and copy of the Declaration of Independence, though a few additional primary sources received enough views to be listed within the top 29 URLs as well. The Jefferson Papers distributions of views shows a heavy usage of the contextual framework writing included by the Manuscript Division. The Articles and Essays tab on the Jefferson Papers contains a collection of essays and timelines. The heavy usage of these secondary sources compared to primary sources shows that the articles and essays are valued resources. Updating and maintaining its content on a more regular basis could be beneficial for the public. We were not surprised to see that the copy and draft of the Declaration of Independence made up the most views of his collection items, as Jefferson is the primary author and these items are some of the most valued collection items. We wonder, however, how we can lead visitors from valued and well-known items such as the Declaration of Independence, copy and draft, to less known but valuable items.
The Grant Papers had a total of over 4,000 page views in the month of March 2020. This graph represents the top 29 pages viewed in this collection, which makes up almost 1,300 views. As you can see, both secondary and primary sources were popular. By far, the most popular items this month were the personal letters Grant wrote to his wife, Julia. The popularity of the secondary sources shows that researchers are interested in contextual information created by scholars and librarians that can help explain the primary sources. Four of the most popular items viewed are included directly in the featured content on the About the Collections landing page, suggesting the usefulness of this feature to direct users to specific content. Grant's correspondence with his wife was of high interest for patrons, who we hypothesize are interested in learning more about Grant's personal life. According to the data examined during this period, the Jefferson Papers received significantly more traffic than the Grant Papers. This could be for several reasons. Jefferson is generally more well-known as a president than Grant. Jefferson's papers have been available online for about 18 years longer than Grant's have, possibly pulling back return visitors. Finally, the Jefferson papers are easier to navigate, as each item is indexed and described individually, making keyword searches in this collection more effective.
From our initial analysis, a major way our insights can be applied is in the Manuscript Division's LibGuides. As an additional project, Rebekah and I are writing a LibGuide on presidential family correspondences. Knowing that highlighted primary sources receive the most views, we can focus our efforts on making relevant items easy to access and give a variety of suggestions throughout the LibGuide.
Our continued work on our web metrics analysis expands our time frame outside of a single month to get a sense of any patterns in usage over time. We also are comparing the publicity and outreach initiatives that involve either the grant or Jefferson Papers and determine if these forms of collection advocacy had an effect on the digital collections traffic patterns. This will give the staff in the Manuscript Division an indication of what type of media platforms are most effective to pursue in future promotions of their collections.
Serving as junior fellows has been an amazing opportunity for both of us. We want to thank our project mentors in the Manuscript Division for their assistance in our project and guidance in the program. Additionally, we want to thank the staff of the Web Metrics and Analytics Services who kindly pulled the data we are working with, as well as all the staff with the internships and fellowship programs.